Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. In this video, we shall discuss the heat transfer through radiation. In particular, we shall talk about absorption and emission of radiation. Two experiments will be used to study these two aspects of radiation. Let me clarify the term radiation. In the news, when you hear about radiation, it often refers to those harmful ones, such as radiation from nuclear accidents, atomic bomb testing, or leakage of nuclear waste. This radiation should be named more correctly as radioactive radiations. They are not the radiations in our discussion here. The term radiation is often used to collectively refer to visible light, X-ray, microwave, ultraviolet, infrared radiations, etc. When used in this way, the term radiation is equivalent to electromagnetic waves, which is a large family of radiation. However, in the electromagnetic wave, only infrared is responsible for the heat transfer due to temperature difference. Therefore, the radiation we are going to talk about is infrared radiation only. Infrared radiation is invisible to us. However, we can feel the warmth of infrared radiation. For example, when you sit near a fire during barbecue, you can feel the heat. It is the infrared radiation from the fire. Likewise, under strong sunlight, you can feel the infrared radiation from the sun. What kind of objects emit infrared radiation? The answer is all objects. In fact, all objects above the absorption seal emit infrared radiation. When an object absorbs more infrared radiation than it emits, there is a net transfer of energy to the object. This object is heated, which may lead to a temperature rise. When we feel the warmth from the sun, there is an energy transfer from the sun to our body. However, the space between the sun and the earth is a vacuum. Therefore, this energy transfer must not be through conduction or convection, because both cannot take place in vacuum. Instead, radiation is used to describe the energy transfer process. Radiation is a process of heat transfer which does not require any medium. The energy is transferred in the form of infrared radiation. When radiation falls on an object, it is partially absorbed and partially reflected. Which color is a better absorber of infrared radiation? Silver or black? Let's carry out an experiment to find out the answer. The apparatus used include two alcohol-in-glass thermometers, one coated with silvery aluminum foil and the other with dull black paper. We also need a radiant heater. Place the two thermometers at equal distances from the heater. Turn on the heater and record the temperature regularly. Result shows that the thermometer coated with black paper rises much more than the one coated with aluminum foil. This implies that black surfaces are good absorbers of radiation and silvery surfaces are poor absorbers of radiation. A good absorber of radiation is also a poor reflector of radiation. Therefore, black surfaces are poor reflectors, silvery surfaces are good reflectors. The result has important implications. For example, firstly, winter uniforms are in dark color. This helps to absorb radiation from the sun. On the other hand, summer uniforms are in light color. This helps to reflect radiation from the sun. Secondly, the water pipes in solar water heaters are painted in dark to enhance absorption of radiation. Thirdly, fuel storage tanks are painted in white or silvery to make them a poor absorber of radiation. Fourthly, oil pipes have silvery surface to reflect radiation. Finally, aluminum foil has a shiny and a dull side. For faster cooking, food should be wrapped with the dull side facing out. As I have just mentioned, all objects emit infrared radiations. A hotter object emits more radiation. Besides, we want to know which color is a better emitter of radiation. Silvery or dull black? Let's carry out an experiment to find out the answer. The apparatus used include two flasks, one painted in black and the other in silver. Fill the flask with the same amount of hot water. Allows the flask to cool and record the temperature regularly. Results show that the temperature of the black flask falls more quickly. This implies that dull black surfaces are good emitters of radiation. Since the temperature of the silver flask falls slowly, silvery surfaces are poor emitters of radiation. Again, this result has important implications. For example, firstly, radiators in cars are painted in dull black to remove excessive heat efficiently. Secondly, spacesuits of astronauts are white in color. This prevents heat loss by radiation. Thirdly, the shiny side of an aluminum foil can prevent heat loss due to radiation. The shiny side should be facing out in wrapping food for later use. Fourthly, shiny water tank is used in a solar water heater to reduce heat loss by radiation. Question: why are the chips in circuit boards in dull black color? Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. You are welcome to comment on the answers of other people. Summary, radiation is a process of heat transfer which does not require any medium. Energy is carried by infrared radiation. Silvery surface is a poor radiation absorber and a poor radiation emitter. Dull back surface is a good radiation absorber and a good radiation emitter. I hope this video can help you understand more about radiation. Thank you for watching.